would you offer it for?
I'd probably be a bit higher than that.
$100?
I like Quiver.com a lot. I'd probably put it in my 150 to 250 category.
So you want to hire Andrew, not Brian, for this transaction?
Well, look, but here's the deal. I say 150 to 250, but there are two different markets out there. There is the market of, here, I've got this domain, this is what I believe it's worth, and I'm gonna hold it until the highest and best use case buyer comes knocking on my door, I'm in a position of leverage, and I'm gonna wait for them to get to my price. And in that case, you will achieve the highest retail value of your name. That you would believe is the highest retail value of the name, and if you're somewhat accurate, you and the buyer, in the right time, right buyer, the stars align, and you get that price. But that's not the case with most domain sales. And so, I do believe that that's $150,000 to $250,000 domain for the right buyer at the right time, under the right circumstances. But again, that is not the way most domain sales happen. If you come knocking on my door, and you say, look, Andrew, I want you to go sell Quiver.com for me. Probably the likelihood of a sale probably takes place. I would go to the higher end of Brian's range in the 50, 75. I'd probably ask for like 125. And I would expect a sale in that 75 to 100 range, you know, sort of in that's the sweet spot. That's where I would really, you know, the high probability of a sale to me would be in that range. I think it's worth more, but in a proactive sale where we are not in a position of leverage, we are going on knocking on a buyer's door and saying, you should buy this domain, then you're going to have to discount what you believe the price to be because you're not in the position of leverage. You're saying, I'm soliciting you to buy this domain, and therefore it's my job to tell you what I think the price is, and it's a different market valuation than if they're coming to you.